Hair fall is one of the most common concerns patients or clients walk to the clinic with. And the number of cases I see for hair fall is just increasing day by day. There are many factors for this. It's probably the deteriorating lifestyle, the worsening environmental conditions, and also genetic predisposition. So what are the treatments that we have for hair fall? Well, there are some oral medications, topical applications that we do, but in today's video, we're only going to be talking about one particular treatment that's available for hair fall. And the best part about this video is I am going to be getting this treatment on myself and demonstrating this for you guys. So PRP and growth factor concentrate treatments are the procedures that are usually done for hair fall. So what do these treatments do? First of all, they help in reducing the hair fall. They help in stimulating the hair follicle, increasing the thickness of the hair shaft, and thereby making your hair more voluminous and more thick. So in this procedure, you get growth factor concentrate, preloaded tubes of growth factor concentrate in tubes like these. So you would be able to draw about 4 ml of blood in each of these tubes, which would be giving you 2 ml of the growth factor concentrate. So all you have to do is extract the blood and load it into the tubes like this and gently shake them about 6 to 10 times, very gently. And then you'll have to rest the tubes for about 30 minutes. So that's what these two little tubes are resting here, because my blood is here getting mixed up with the growth factor concentrate, and we'll have to wait patiently for 30 minutes. So ideally in one session, we use 4 tubes. So that would be giving you about 8 ml of growth factor extract, and we would be injecting onto the entire area that's affected. But if you have a very tiny area and you don't have a lot of hair fall, then we would be probably using just 2 tubes, but minimum of 2 tubes are to be used. So yeah, you would be getting either 4 ml of extract or 8 ml of extract. In cases who have bald patches or very thin hair, it is easier to apply topical numbing cream so that the area becomes numb and the procedure can be more tolerable. But in clients, for example, like me, who have full thickness hair, it is not very easy to apply the topical numbing cream. So I am choosing to go without the top lap or the topical numbing cream. I know I'm brave. But yeah, so let's see if this procedure is tolerable or not. Resting, we have sent the tubes for centrifugation, and the centrifugation was done at 3400 RMP for about 10 minutes. And as you can see, the growth factor concentrate has separated itself and come to the top of the tube, while the rest of the unwanted cells of the blood are settled down below at the bottom of the tube. And we would be getting about 2 ml from each tube. The 2 ml of growth factor concentrated would be derived, so a total of 4 ml is what we are going to get. And they're going to inject that on my scalp. So I'm all set to get injected. So I've done PRP injections on myself just a couple of days ago because I was experiencing hair fall. And I sailed through the procedure. Probably I would have broke some bones or squeezed some muscle or tendons out of the person's hand I was holding, but I sailed through the procedure. So having said that, PRP is slightly painful procedure which involves multiple pricks onto the affected area. It's not like jumping out of seat pain. You can sail through the procedure because I am somebody who is extremely pain sensitive and I could finish the procedure. So when I was trying this growth factor concentrate, I was told that the pain would be very minimum to less. All you could feel is the injection prick. That makes sense because growth factor serum essentially is acellular, while PRP has active components of cells in it, which makes it a little more inflammatory and painful procedure. But since growth factor is kind of acellular, it shouldn't be that painful. Let's see. I still have one more hand that I can break the bones off. All the best. Okay. So all I can feel is the prick pain, but I cannot feel any inflammatory sensation or any burning sensation when the fluid actually goes in. That happens with PRP. So all I'm feeling is the prick pain, and this is great. Now, since I'm comfortable with the procedure, I think we can discuss more about this procedure. Thank you for your hand. So the growth factor concentrate or the PRP per se has a lot of growth factors in it which would help in stimulating the hair, reducing the hair fall, increasing the thickness of your hair eventually. So what are the growth factors that are essentially present in this? Now there are several growth factors like platelet-derived growth factor, insulin-like growth factor, and TGF. All of these things would help in stimulating the hair growth, stimulating the bulb of the hair, thereby reducing the hair fall and increasing the hair growth. And certain growth factors like vascular endothelial growth factor essentially helps in angiogenesis, which means it helps in forming new blood vessels. So this particular growth factor is present around the hair in the anagen phase of the hair. So this would help in stimulating the production of new blood vessels or also stimulating the existing blood vessels and thereby improving the blood circulation to the roots of the hair. And now we all know that blood is a structure that carries nutrients to organs like hair. So by improving the blood circulation, you're also improving the nutrient value that is reaching the roots of your hair, which means you are making your hair more stronger, which means your hair is becoming resistant and improving the tensile strength of your hair eventually, which means you are improving the volume of your hair and decreasing the hair fall. So the other growth factors like the fibroblast growth factor and epidermal growth factor are also present in this epidermal growth factor concentrate and in PRP also, which would also stimulate the hair growth. Now, the growth factor concentrate has much more higher concentration of these growth factors as compared to the PRP. So usually we suggest the patients or clients to go ahead with the growth factor concentrate than PRP because the pain factor, now I know personally that the pain factor is much less and there is definitely more concentrate of these growth factors in growth factor concentrate vials or tubes as compared to the plain individual PRP. So since the concentrate of growth factors is much higher in the growth factor concentrate tubes as compared to the normal PRP, the number of sessions that you would require to achieve a desired result is also much lesser with the growth factor concentrate. So for example, if you require about 6 to 7 sessions with PRP, all you would need is about 3 or 4 sessions maximum with the growth factor concentrated tubes. So what are you getting? You're getting much faster result with less pain, more comfort. But of course, this comes with a cost because the growth factor concentrate tubes are a little expensive. The procedure is slightly expensive as compared to a normal PRP, but it's definitely worth it because you're cutting down a number of sessions and you're also cutting down a lot of pain and discomfort that you would go through. So after the procedure, the post care is pretty much similar with both PRP and growth factor concentrate. You could resume to your normal social or work life just immediately after the procedure. So we call this like a lunch break procedure. You could take shower after a couple of hours, like head bath or head shower. You can take after a couple of hours, not right away, but you can resume with your activities right, like immediately after. You can even go work out immediately after this particular procedure. So how many sessions would one require and what's the frequency? Well, ideally we would recommend about 3 to 4 sessions if it's a growth factor concentrate treatment, or if it's PRP, I would recommend about 6 to 7 sessions. And the duration between these sessions is usually 20 to 30 days. So you do it once in a month essentially. And now after that, I would like to call my clients back for follow-up or just like a maintenance session once in 4 or 5 months. Now I do this because all of us have deteriorating lifestyle, very bad environmental conditions, poor nutrition. All of this leads to constant hair. Now tell me, I've not seen one person tell I don't have hair fall. So all of us face hair fall, some more than the other. But it's always nice to enrich your hair, the roots of your hair with good growth factors so that you do not face a severe hair fall issue. So in order to just maintain the growth of your hair, I would recommend you do this once in 4 or 5 months. But if you have some severe hair fall, then we would be giving you topical applications, oral medications or oral supplements along with the growth factor concentrate or PRP treatment. So now we're done with the GFC injections, after which we would usually do gentle massaging on the scalp, which would help in better seepage of this growth factor concentrate or the PRP, what we've injected onto the scalp, followed by which we would be asking our clients to take light therapy. So that's what I'm going to do now. So light therapy again further stimulates the root of your hair for the reduction of the hair fall and also better hair. So this would go on for about 10 minutes. So this treatment, as I just mentioned, is called as the low-level laser light therapy. This would help in stimulating the roots of your hair, thereby decreasing the hair fall and improving the hair growth again. So this is typically done after I do the PRP or the growth factor concentrate injections, and the duration would last anywhere between 10 to 20 minutes of this treatment with different energies. The energy, the time will all depend upon number of sessions you're taking, the severity of your hair fall, so on and so forth. So I hope this session helped you guys to understand much more about the growth factor concentrate treatment in treating hair fall. If you have any more queries, you can reach to us on info@dnskinclinic.in or on our social media handles. Until then, you guys stay healthy and stay happy.